Let's use Excel to create this dynamic butterfly chart in 2 minutes. Save this for Monday if you don't have time right now. First, we want to see our population in millions. So we need to convert this by dividing by 10 to the sixth and then do the same on the right side for men. So we're going to take that cell and divide it by 10 to the sixth. That's going to knock down all of those zeros and we're going to have two digits. So we need to change this, the number of decimals, and then do the same thing, double click it down for women and then change the decimals. Next, we're going to use conditional formatting. So let's go up to data bars and then more options here. And we want to check show bar only because we want to remove the numbers. These each should be number and our minimum is 0 and our maximum is 50 million. And then we can change this to pink and we're doing a right to left bar. Hit OK. And let's repeat this step for men. So select everything, conditional formatting, data bars, and then more rules. And same thing, check show bar only. And then we're going to go with number in both of these. And our max, again, is 50 million. Let's change this to a different shade of blue. And then this time, it's going to be left to right. Hit OK. Next, we need to copy Control-C all of our population values, right-click, and then go into Paste Special, and we want to change this to a linked picture. This way, you can move the numbers in place, and it's linked, so any changes you make are going to appear. So do the exact same thing to the right, copy it with Control-C, and then right-click and find the linked picture option off to the right, and then move it in place. I actually would like these to be bold so they really stand out. And then white is probably a better option when you're using darker colors. So go back to your original data and let's change that font color to white and bold. And now it appears in your bars. So next, what we want to do is a little bit of formatting. So we're going to select both columns and adjust it a little bit so that they're both the same width. And then let's select all of the age bucket information and center it. And then let's move women over to the right. So we'll do a right alignment and men is already left aligned. So that looks pretty good. So let's change that to bold. And then let's select all of this info here because we want to add a few borders in. So we're going to hit Control+1 to pull up the format window. And you can pick any type of border. I'm going with that type of line in a light gray. And then I'm going to add it in the middle. So any horizontal border, basically, you can click on those, hit OK. And now you've got some borders. But you know what? It would have been better to have a thicker one underneath our main heading. So let's do it again. So Control+1 will bring that window up. And then let's make that a thicker line. Click on the bottom, hit OK. Perfect.